a psychrometer. All right, so here are two different types of psychrometers. And there's a sling and an aspirating. So here on the left is our sling psychrometer, and our aspirating one here is the one on the right. And basically what we have is we have the wet bulb, which is a bulb. Both of these thermometers are the same, so you've got two thermometers. And one thermometer is covered with a wick, and that wick is wettened with just some water. And sometimes these are configured so you can always have some like water reservoir. But again, so one bulb is exposed and one is covered with a wick. And so now, because this thermometer is covered, when you drive that whipped thermometer through the air, it will give you the wet bulb temperature. It'll give you the adiabatic saturation temperature because that thermometer will continue to be wettened by the wick, and the wick will continue to evaporate until it gets cool enough that it can't evaporate anymore, until it moves down, going back here, before it moves down until it hits the adiabatic saturation temperature here on the vapor dome. Once it hits that point, it will stop evaporating and the wick won't cool the thermometer anymore. And so we've hit the adiabatic saturation temperature. And so we have two temperatures now. We have a wet bulb temperature and we have a dry bulb temperature. And so here for the what's happening in the aspirating one is, instead of taking the sling thermometer and we hold this handle and we rotate about the handle, the aspirating draws in air over our thermometers as opposed to driving it through the air. And so I'm actually going to show you an example of that.
All right, so we're going to look at how to use a sling psychrometer. And this is what it looks like. A little bit close up, we have two thermometers. So one is the dry bulb thermometer on the bottom. This is the wet bulb thermometer on top. I've already wettened the wick with just some water. You can see the temperatures are off a little bit right now, but it doesn't really matter because we're going to drive it through the air. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to do this for about a minute. Actually, I have my timer here. I'm going to do this for about a minute. I had a student previously that came through the class, and he was a fire jumper and would go in to work on fires and put out fires in forests in Oregon. And what he said is they would run this for a minute, and I would do it about every 30 minutes to an hour just to check the conditions of where they were at to make sure that they didn't have to worry about fires taking off much more quickly if they're really dry air, as well as looking at the brush around them, that being too dry. So this is something that's done commonly there. Probably something more like the aspirating one example that I showed you in the slide. That's the one that's probably going to be used more in weather stations as opposed to this one, which is more when you're on the move and going about and doing different stuff. All right, so we'll stop and come back when this is done. All right, so there is 1 minute. So let's see what we got here. So again, the wet bulb's on top here. And I'll turn this so you can see right there. Hopefully you can see about that it is right around, what do you see there, 58?
Mm-hmm.
And then for dry bulb, so on the bottom, get it to where you can see the red.
There.
All right, so there you can see it's right around 70.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so we got 70 on the dry bulb, and we had 58 on the dry bulb, the wet bulb. All right, so 70 and 58. So what we do here now is we're going to close it, and we're going to look at these scales. So we have 70 degrees Fahrenheit on the wet bulb, it's the dry bulb, right? So the dry bulb was 70, and the wet bulb was 58. So we're going to line up the 70 with the 58. So we'll pull it out, so we get the 70 on the dry bulb, and we get 58 right there on the wet bulb. So they're lined up, 70 and 58. And then we take this Y, that's pointing at where we're at on the percent RH, so the percent relative humidity. And so that ends up being 50%. So according to our sling psychrometer, we have 50% relative humidity in this room. All right, so let's go back to the presentation. I'll show you about another way, if we have the wet and dry bulb temperatures, that we can calculate what the relative humidity is.